Hello, myself Sushmita, working as Assistant Professor, Faculty of Agriculture Science, Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research. Today, I'm going to deliver the lecture from the course Fundamentals of Entomology, topic Type of Metamorphosis and Immature Stages of Insect. So here, this video will comprising of about two topics, that is growth and development. So none other than about the metamorphosis, and second one is immature stage of insect and their types. So first we start from metamorphosis. So what is metamorphosis? First of all, metamorphosis is just defining about the growth. So metamorphosis is about changing in growth and development of an insect which undergoes during their life cycle. So we can simply say insect, after they hatch out from the egg, they will keep on growing. So they will keep on eating and they will take a nutrient. By that they will keep on grow and they will move to one stage to another stage, from egg to adult stage. So here these changes are happened by their growth and it lead to development of an insect. Here the change in growth and development of an insect is called as a metamorphosis, which undergoes during their life cycle from their birth to their maturity. From birth to their maturity means some insects may stop their growth phase before adult or in between the adult stage. So that's why it is said during their life cycle from birth to maturity. So overall, the metamorphosis is nothing but change in growth and development of an insect during their life stages, that is during their life cycle from birth to maturity. So this is metamorphosis. So metamorphosis, their growth and development in insect is not same for all insects. So this may be vary according to their living habit and habitat. So here there are certain types. So in that, the four important type of metamorphosis are ametabola, hemimetabola, parametabola and holometabola. So one by one I will tell. First about ametabola. So ametabola has another name, it is no metamorphosis. So we know what is metamorphosis. What is no metamorphosis? So here it is one of a primitive type of metamorphosis. I'm saying about ametabola, it is a most primitive type of metamorphosis. Why? Because here these insects have only three stages in their life, that it is egg stage, young one stage, and another one is adult stage. So egg stage, it is a common stage for all insects. So each and every insect have a egg stage. So it is a mandatory stage of a insect, egg stage. After the egg stage, so here I give an example, silverfish. So here take an example of silverfish. Silverfish, once it hatch out from the egg, how it will be means, it will just look like an adult. The hatching insect, which resembles the adult in all aspects, but except for the size. So the only difference between the adult and young one of the silverfish is their size. So here the example is silverfish. Once it hatch out from the egg, it will be look same as adult. The young one and adult will be same in all aspects. Their appendages will be same, their legs, their type of body, their head, and the additional appendages also look same, but their change is their size. So here, while we are identifying silverfish, based upon the size only, we have to come to an end. This is an young one, this is an adult. And also another one, in this type of ametabola type of insect, that is ametabola metamorphosis type of insect, their young one is called as juvenile. So here the young one of silverfish is called as juvenile. And also another one important point in ametabola, it is the molting which continues throughout their life cycle. So give up. So the molting, that is molting is nothing but shedding of old cuticle simultaneously accompanying of new cuticle. The cuticle removing and a cuticle growth, this is the molting part. So the molting is in a first part of their growth. Their change starts from molting. So here the change, that means the growth of insect, will be continue from young one till their life. That means throughout the adult stage, these changes is happening. So only change is their size. So look at the image. So here this is about the ametabolous development. So you can see the egg that you can easily identify, and next to egg it is newly hatched juvenile from the egg, that is a silverfish. So here we can say, here we can see the antennal types. So the antennal type is the same, their body type is same, their additional styli also look at same, but their only difference is their size. So these type of growth and development in an insect, these kind of metamorphosis is called as a ametabolous metamorphosis. So this is the first type. Second type is hemimetabola. Hemimetabola is otherwise called as incomplete metamorphosis. Hemimetabola otherwise called as incomplete metamorphosis. So here the examples are dragonfly, damselfly and mayfly. So this is the dragonfly nymph, and how it is emerging from the nymph and how it become an adult. So what are all the growth and development in hemimetabola type of metamorphosis? Here these insects are also have three stages in their life, namely egg, young one and adult. As the ametabola, hemimetabola are having the same life stages, egg, young one and adult. The young ones are aquatic and are called as a naiads. So here it is somewhat different. Young ones are living in aquatic region, either in a pond or lake. So that's why their young one is called as a naiads. And also they breathe by means of tracheal gills. Normally insects don't breathe by gills, but insects, that is dragonfly, damselfly, mayfly, in these three insects, during their naiad stage, that is during their young one stage, they are breathing through their gills only. So they are different from adult in habit and their habitat. So it is not living in a terrestrial area, it is living in aquatic, and it is not eating the food that is present in terrestrial, and it is eating the food present in aquatic area. So it is completely different to the habit and habitat of, when compared to the other young one which is present as an insect in the terrestrial area. So that is a major difference of hemimetabola. Here the young ones are living in aquatic area, that young ones are called as naiad. And another one point here, they breathe by means of tracheal gills. So when coming to the dragonfly naiads, their lower lip is called as a labium. So these labium is also called as a mask. Okay, so here the use of mask is, it is hinged and it is provided with a hook of capturing prey. So it is used to capturing the prey that is near to this naiad. And once it moving to the next stage, that is during their molting or next developmental stage, here these from this naiad or from this nymph, the adult will be emerged. So the adult is nothing but the dragonfly and damselfly, which they develop their wings and it is suited for aerial life. So after the final molting stage, insect have fully developed wings, which is suited for aerial life. So here we can see the dragon naiads, that is can also be called as a nymph, where it is lived in aquatic area and it be breathe through the gills. And once it become an nymph, from the nymph the adult will emerge. So this is about hemimetabola. Hemimetabola is also called, otherwise called as incomplete metamorphosis. Next about parametabola. Parametabola is called as a gradual metamorphosis. Gradual metamorphosis example, cockroach, grasshopper and bugs. So here the young ones are called as nymph. First young ones of ametabola is called as naiads. Young ones of hemimetabola, young ones of ametabola is called as juvenile. Young ones of hemimetabola is called as naiads. Young ones of parametabola is called as nymph. So here these insects are live in terrestrial, and it resembles same as adult in general structure of their body, except their wings and their external genitalial part. So here the difference is their size and their wing development and their genitalial part. other than that, their body, their shape, and some other important features and all same for young one and the adult. So their compound eyes and mouth part are similar to their adult. Both for nymph and adult, they share the same habitat too. Both nymph and adult eat the same food during the nymph and the adult stage. And coming to the wing but externally appear in the last instars only. So during their molting stage from nymph to adult, at the last molting, they will develop their wings. And genitalial development also gradually develop in last instar, the nymph is closely resembled to adult. During the adult stage, it will have all the full genital part and they will have well suited wings will be present. So this is their gradual metamorphosis development. So here simply it is egg stage. From the egg, the nymph will be present. So here it is early nymph and late nymph. So the size is different, so early and late nymph. So here this is a kind of a fly where we can differentiate the nymphs and adult. So it is early nymph, it is late nymph. So once it keep on molting and keep on developing, at the last instar it is developed as a adult. So here look at this bug, the size are same but the wing development is lacking. So we can easily see the wing development is highly lacking when compared to the nymph and the adult. So rest of that, their shape, color, their antennal type, their leg type, body type are same. So this is a gradual metamorphosis. So this is third type. And last type is holometabola. Holometabola is a complete metamorphosis. Example, butterfly, moth, flies and bees. So here these insects are having four life stages, namely egg, larvae, pupae and adult. So majority of insects, that is up to 70%, 60 to 70% of insects are undergoing these complete metamorphosis only. So complete metamorphosis means four stage, egg, larva, pupa and adult stage. So the larva of butterfly, so that is a young one which is hatching from the egg. So the larva of butterflies are called as caterpillars. The larva of butterflies are called as caterpillars. So here these larvae differ greatly from adult. So there's complete difference. They don't have any similar features or similar type of mouth part or whatever may be. It is completely different from the adult. And here for most of the species, the larvae compound eyes are absent. Compound eyes are absent in larvae. At the same time, the lateral ocelli and stomatae are the visual organs. And coming to their mouth part of larvae, their mouth part, it is having a chewing mouth part, it will feed the food, they will bite and eat the food. And their wing development is present internally. Once they get into the one stage to another stage, this wing will be completely develop. So the larval growth is complete. It will transform into pupa. So I told it has four stage: egg, larvae, pupae and adult. Once it complete the larval stage, it will be transformed into the next stage called pupa. So how it will transform means it will keep on molt. So at least a larvae will do five molting. It will remove their old skin and the new skin will be developed at least five times. So here once it complete their five time of molting, at the last fifth instar, it will be completely transformed into as a pupa. So the pupa, it is a resting stage of a butterfly's mother. It will be completely rest, and after the pupa, it will become as an adult. So here, not only it will completely rest, it will also don't feed. During the non-feeding pupal stage, these larval tissue will disintegrate and adult organ will build up. So it will become as a cocoon. Inside the cocoon, the larvae is changed as a pupa. So it don't have any activity, don't feed. During that time, these larval tissues which are present inside the cocoon will disintegrate and they build up the adult organ. So this is the growth and development stage of butterflies, moth and bees. So this is called as a holometabola. So here look at this diagram. So here this is egg. From the egg, the larva stage, the larva is hatching out and it become as pupa and it become as adult. So it's a butterfly stage. So these kind of metamorphosis are common metamorphosis, where the majority of insects are having these kind of metamorphosis only. Egg stage, from the egg larva will hatch out, from that it will keep on molt and it will become as a pupae, and from the pupa the full developed beautiful butterfly will emerge. So this is the last type of metamorphosis development, that is holometabolous development, where it is otherwise called as a complete metamorphosis. So in before we discussed about the metamorphosis, what is metamorphosis and what are all the types which is present in metamorphosis. So here next, in this metamorphosis stage, leaving the adult stage, all the before stage like egg or young one or egg larval pupal stage are called as a immature stage. So as the adult have different features, different colors and different types, also the egg stage, larval stage, pupal stage also having different kind or different types depend upon the insects. So one by one we will discuss. First start from egg. So egg, as I told, it is a first stage in all insect, is egg. So majority of insect are oviparous. So majority, the 80% of insect are oviparous. Here the egg stage is inconspicuous, inexpensive and inactive. They don't have any movement, they are inconspicuous and inexpensive. And also, what are all the things which is present in egg? It contains yolk, which supports the embryonic development. So it is the developing thing as an next young one. So it can a yolk which is supports the embryonic development, and they will lay their egg. So the eggs are laid under certain conditions, so where the food is available immediately for the future young one. So if it lay their eggs either in underside of a leaf or near the plant or under the soil mean, it will lay which is suitable for the young ones. So eggs are laid either individually or in group. So some insect will lay single egg, some insect will lay their eggs in group, so it may be vary. So the outer protective shell of the egg is called as a chorion. Inside the yolk will be present, which is supporting the embryonic development. Outside, the protective shell of egg is called as a chorion. Near the anterior end of the egg, there is small opening is there. So that opening is called as a micropyle, which allow the sperm to entry for the fertilization. The small opening will be present at the anterior end, that is called as a micropyle. So here the chorion, which is the outer cover, have variety of textures. So this may be also varied according to the egg type, and the cell and the shape of the eggs are also vary widely. So how it is varied? So types of eggs. So as I told, the insects may lay their eggs singly or they lay their eggs in group. So in that single laid and egg laid in group have different types. So in that first one is singly laid eggs, that is sculptured egg, elongated egg, rounded egg, nits and egg float. Egg laid in group, there are 7 important types, that is pedicellate egg, barrel shaped egg, utica, egg pod, case, egg mass and egg raft. First one is singly laid egg. In singly laid egg, the sculptured eggs, example castor butterfly, so the eggs are laid singly. So here we can see the singly laid eggs, which is under surface of a leaf, where it is a microscopic image, where the chorion, which is having the reticulate marking and ridges. So we can see the ridges over the surface of chorion. So this is the identification of sculptured egg. So it is example castor butterfly. Next one is elongated egg. So here these is example taken sorghum shoot fly. So how this elongated egg will be? The elongated eggs are cigar shape. So So we can see the eggs here, which is very very minute, but the shape is cigar shape. That's why it is coming under elongated type of egg. Next one is rounded egg. So the eggs are either spherical or globular. So it's a normal type of egg. Example, citrus butterfly. So it will be singly spherical and globular type of egg. Next one is nit. So here this is the eggs of head louse, is called as a nit. So it is cemented to the base of the hair. So the chorion, which is tightly attached to the hair, the base is tightly attached to the hair. So here there is egg stigma at the posterior end, which assist in attachment. At the anterior region, there is a oval lid which is lifted at the time of hatching. So here you can see at their posterior end, they are having the stigma which is actually catching hairs. And at the anterior, in the starting point, these end will be oval shape. These oval shaped lid will keep on lift at the time of hatching. So this is nit. Next one is egg with float. Example is mosquito. So here the mosquito egg will be a boat shaped egg. So here the boat shape with a conspicuous float on the either side. So they can either float or they can float on the either side of the body. Normally the eggs of mosquito will be present in water. That's why their structure also made like this. So the lateral sides are very expanded. So here we can see the lateral sides are very expanded, and here this is an example of a mosquito egg. So egg with the float, they will float on the water. So here the identification is the lateral sides are expanded. So this is about the eggs laid in singly laid egg type. Next one is egg laid in group. So first one is pedicellated egg. So eggs laid in silken stack of about, it's just look like this. So it is about 1.25 length in a group of plant. So here you can see the stalks. So it just look like a thread. At the tip of the thread, the eggs will be. So this just laid in group. So here the length is 1.25 mm. Example, green lace wing fly. So this is green lace wing fly. It will lay their eggs in group like this. So the silken stalk will be 1.25 millimeter. So at the tip of the silken stalk, the eggs are laid. Next one is barrel shaped egg. Example, stink bug. So here this is stink bug. So you can see how it is laid their egg. So this egg is barrel shaped. So this is just look like a miniature batteries. So it is just look like a small batteries. So they deposit in a compactly, they deposit as a compactly arranged mass in the plants, either leaf or a stem. So the shape of the egg is barrel shape. Next one is utike. So here the eggs are like this. Example, cockroach. The cockroach will lay egg like this only. So the eggs are deposited by cockroach in a brown bean like chitinous capsule. So it is just look like a brown color bean like a capsule, if the eggs will be there. So each utike consists of double layered wafer production. Two parallel rows of eggs will be present. So inside that, inside the double layer production, two parallel rows of eggs will be present. Each utike have 16 eggs which is arranged in the two rows. So here this utike are carried for several days, producing it will be came out from the abdomen just a period to the oviposition in a scheduled spot. It will carry their egg for long time. Once it is known that they are from the egg, the young one will come, means then only it will hatch their egg. Then only it will catch their egg. Along the top, there is a crest which have a smaller pore which permit the gaseous exchange without undue the water loss. So here this chitinase AKS is produced out of the secretion of the collateral gland which is present in cockroach. So this is the Urtica type of egg which is laid by an adult cockroach. The next type is egg pod. So the grasshoppers are laid these kind of eggs. So grasshoppers secrete a frothy matters or frothy material that encases a egg mass which is deposited in the ground. So here the egg mass lack a definite covering on the top of the egg. The frothy substance are hardened to form a plug which prevents the drying of egg. And next type is egg case. So here the mantids are example. Mantid deposit their egg on twig in the foamy secretion called as spermline. So which eventually harden to produce an egg case or urtica. So it just looked like a urtica. Inside the egg case, eggs are assigned in a row inside the egg chamber. So it is just look like a urtica or a case. Inside the case, the eggs are laid inside the chamber. And next one is egg mass. So egg here the eggs are laid by moth. The moth lay eggs in group in a mass of its body has. They use their anal tuft. That means the anal tuft have found at the end of the abdomen. It is mainly used for the purpose. Example, rice stem borer. Rice stem borer normally lay these kind of egg. Female silkworm moth under the capacity, they will each female can lay eggs on egg cord. Each egg mass is called as a DFL, that is disease-free laying. The another one type is egg graft. In mosquitoes, example, the Culex mosquito, the eggs are laid in a compact mass consisting of 200 to 300 eggs called as egg graft. It is particularly laid only in water. So this is about egg and their immature stage. The next stage, it is a larvae. So the larval stage, it's an actively growing stage. So it is one of the important immature stage between the egg and pupal stage of an insect which is having the complete metamorphosis. So here this stage differs radially from the adult. So what are all the types? So here the types of larvae are only three types, that is oligopod, polypod and apodous. First one is oligopod. So here the thoracic legs are well developed and their abdominal legs are absent. So here there are having the another two types that is can be mentioned as subtypes, that is cambodiform and scarabiform. How this oligopod larvae will be? So here you can see the cambodiform larvae. So they are also called for their resemblance. So they are these kind of diplurant genus or cambodiae. Their body is just elongated, depressed, and they are depressed dorsoventral body, and they are well sclerotized. And another one thing is their head is progenathos type of head, and the thoracic legs are very long, and here they are having a pair of abdominal cerci, and the larvae are generally predators and are very active. Example, grubs of antlion or grubs of ladybird beetle. So another subtype that is called as scarabiform. So here the body is C-shaped, snout and sub-cylindrical type. So here the head is well developed and it is a hardened head, and their thoracic legs are somewhat short, and the caudal process are absent. Here the larvae is very sluggish. It is just look like a sluggish larvae burrowing into the wood or in the soil. Example, grubs of rhinoceros beetle. So these kind of larvae are called scarabiform larvae. Next one is polypod or usiform larvae. So here the body consists of elongated trunk, just look like a long elongated trunk with the sclerotized head capsule. So head capsule is sclerotized, and here the head bears a pair of powerful mandibles which is used for eating tear up the vegetation, and the two group of single lensed stemmatas will present. Stemmatas are present, which are found on the either side of the head, which constitute their visual organ. And the antenna is very short, and they are having three pairs of thoracic legs and up to five pairs of unjoined abdominal legs are present. And also here the prolegs are present. Prolegs will be present in polypod larvae, which is otherwise called as usiform larvae. So here these polypod larvae are having different subtypes. So here thoracic leg segments and the end in the cleft, which are having some holding onto the leaves. They are having different types of larvae under this. So based upon their legs or based upon their walking habit, these are differentiated. So here this abdominal segments are 3 to 6, and 10 typical bear prolegs will be present in most of the caterpillars, either in the larva of moth and butterfly. What are all that? Hairy caterpillar, slug caterpillar, semi-looper and looper. So how this will be? The hairy caterpillar, normally we know in red carry caterpillar or moringa caterpillars and all, they will have more number of hairs on their body. So the body has maybe dense, sparse, and it is arranged in tuft. So it is about their hair. The hair will be arranged in a dense, sparse, or it is arranged in tuft. And these hair may cause irritation while we touch them. Okay, so example, red hairy caterpillar. So first one. And second subtype is slug caterpillar. So here this larva is very thick, short, snout and fleshy too. And about their head, the larval head is very small and it is retracted, and the thoracic legs are very very small. Abdominal legs are absent. They don't have abdominal segments, and abdominal segmentation is very distinct. We can see their segmentations clearly. And these larvae are having a poisonous spines. That spine is called as a scoli. The slug caterpillar, they are having a poisonous spine. That spine is called scoli. So here it is distributed, these spine, it is distributed all over the body. So here such larvae is also called as platyform larvae. Slug caterpillars are also called as platyform larvae. Next one is semi-looper. So either it will have 3 or 4 pairs of prolegs are present, and these prolegs are either wanting and rudimentary in either in the third or in the fourth segment of their abdomen. So here look at this image. This is example of a castor semi-looper. So here this pair of legs are present in the third and the fourth segment, and in between they don't have any prolegs. So that's why their movement is very different when compared to the other caterpillar. So like the semi-looper, looper also same. So here the looper is having the another name called measuring worm or eighth measurer or inch worm. So these type of larvae, they have only 2 pairs of prolegs. So present in the 6th and the 10th abdominal segment. So either only 2 legs will be present, one in 6, another one in the 10th. Okay, for example, dentia looper. For example, dentia looper. So third important type is apodous type of larvae. So here these are the larvae without the appendage for locomotion. Based on the degree of development and the sclerotization of their head capsule, there are 3 subtypes are there. That is eucephalos, hemicephalos and acephalos. So eucephalos larvae. So the larvae with well-developed head capsule with the functional mandibles, maxilla, stemmata and antenna. So these kind of larvae, and with the mandible which act transversely. Example, larvae of mosquito and grubs of red palm weevil. The larvae with well-developed head capsule with the functional mandibles and maxilla, this is their primitive thing. And next one is hemicephalos. So the head capsule is reduced and it can be drawn into thorax. So head and thorax are either it can be look like a merged or it is same. So here the mandibles act vertically. Example, larvae of housefly and robber fly. So here you can see the robber fly and horse fly larvae. And next one is acephalos. So here the head capsule is absent. So the important larvae where the head capsule is absent. And the mouth part consists of a pair of proterbicial curved mouth hook, which is associated with the internal sclerites. So these, they are also called as vermiform larvae, or it is called as maggots. Example, maggots, the larvae of housefly. So this is about the larvae. The next immature stage, or the last immature stage, is pupa. So the pupa, this is the, it is a resting stage and it is an inactive stage in all holometabolous insects. So pupa is only present in holometabola type. In that holometabola type, these stages completely resting and inactive stage. During this stage, these insects are incapable of feeding and it is quiescent. At this transitional stage, the larval characters are which present inside the pupa will destroy completely and the new adult characters are created. So in this stage, the pupa are, again, they are having different types of pupa according to the insects. So there are three important types, that is octectype, extractype and choractype. So first one is octectype, where the mouth part, their legs and wings are in incomplete formed structure. They are glued down as an internal part as a pupal case. So here you can see, so here their egg, leg and the wings are easily can be seen. So it is just look like a glued or it is sticky with one another, just look like that. So this is the octectype. Example, Lepidopterus. So for butterflies, most of the time these type of pupa will be seen. Next one is extractype, where the developing wings, mouth part, legs are visible externally. So there it is somewhat can be seen internally, but here we can see it is in externally. Example, Hymenopteran pupa and Coleopteran pupa. So here this is the pupal stage. So we can externally see their development by stage by stage. And it is crowhead type, where the extract pupa is formed within the larval skin. So it will be covered as a skin and the exterior is generally smooth and it is just look like a seed. Example, Diptera. So these pupa are the next stage of larvae. Normally this is very inactive and they don't feed. At the same time, these pupa stages need a protection because they don't have any movement. They can't escape from the enemies. So these pupils are need a protection. So generally the pupal stage lacks mobility. So hence it is most vulnerable to the enemies. To get a protection against the adverse condition, that means a temperature or heavy rain or the winter or from the natural enemies, these pupa is enclosed in a protective cover that is called as cocoon. It is not just become as pupa, it is just to protect the produce their outer cover. That outer cover is called as a cocoon. Based on the nature and based on the material used for preparation of a cocoon, there are several types of cocoons are there. What are all the types of cocoon? So here the types of cocoon: silken cocoon, earthen cocoon, hairy cocoon, frassy cocoon, fibrous cocoon and puparium. So in these different types of cocoons are using different materials. So first, silken cocoon. These cocoons are made up of a silk, where these silks are produced by the insect from their salivary gland. Saliva, it is turned as a silk and it is secreted from their salivary gland. And examples are silk worm. And next type of cocoon is earthen cocoon. So here it is a mixture of soil and saliva. It will make a case or a cocoon. Inside the cocoon, it will become as a pupae. And next one is hairy cocoon. By using their body hairs, by using their body tuft, it will make a case or a cocoon. Inside the cocoon, it will become a pupae. Frasi cocoon, that is nothing but fras plus saliva. Example, coconut black-headed caterpillar. Next one is fibrous cocoon. By using the fibers, example, red palm weevil. Red palm weevil and all, they will just collect the fiber from the coconut tree or palm tree and make that fiber as a cocoon or a case. Inside the cocoon, it will become as a pupae. So it is one of a good protective covering for them. And the puparium, last one, puparium, example, housefly, that is a hard and last larval skin. They use their last larval skin, they make their skin as a hardened part, and it does make as a cocoon. So this cocoon is protecting the pupa from their adverse condition and from the natural enemies. So here, this is completely discussed about the type of metamorphosis, that is the growth and development, the stage by stage, what are all the growth is happening. So from the egg, next to the young one, next to the adult. So here, these young one, egg to adult, they are having different kind of growth. That is called as metamorphosis. That metamorphosis, based upon the insect habit and habitat, that is differentiated into different types. So that is in no metamorphosis or incomplete metamorphosis, gradual metamorphosis, or either maybe incomplete metamorphosis. So among this complete metamorphosis, they are having four stages, that is egg, larvae, pupal and adult stage, remaining on all egg, young one and adult stage. So these are all the types of metamorphosis. So in this, during their growth, their egg, larval and pupal stages are termed as a immature stage. These immature stage also having different types, that is their egg stage having different, they will lay their eggs in single or in a group. In, if it is a larvae, means based upon their leg arrangement, based upon their body, it has been classified. If it is in a pupa, means based upon their size and shape, and based upon their cocoons also, it is differentiated. Each and every insect, their growth and the development will happen throughout their maturity and sometime in middle of the adult stage. So here, this growth and development is called metamorphosis. In between the metamorphosis, so immature stages are there. That immature stages are also having different types based upon their habit and habitat. So that's all about this lecture. Thank you.